Hello and welcome to the SWN podcast. We're back for another road trip. And now we're in winter, so you can't see me, as John Cena would say. I am your host, as always, Billy. And yes, we're back on another road trip. This time, we've got two. So this is a Friday night. So sorry you can't see me. Because, you know, if you put the big light on in the middle here, it's illegal. I remember that from my youth. So we're going W3L, Wrestling Showdown. It is happening at the Bishop Mill Hall. And I've literally started driving, so I'm pretty much going to drive the length of my commute here to the show. It's W3L, Wrestling Showdown. It has some things on here to degum the windshield. The Bishop Mill Hall, and I'm looking forward to it. And then the next half of the show will be WrestleZone, Christmas Chaos, Return of the Cage, which I'm looking forward to as well. So we're two shows, 2 days, and we're going to do a road trip episode for it. So it's not so much of a road trip in this first part, because I'm going to Bishop Mill Hall in Elgin, and I live in Lismurdy in Elgin. And I'm just going down, I don't know what street this is, I don't know this place, I just live here, I know where stuff is, couldn't tell you where things, I couldn't direct you to places in this place. But what we've got on tap tonight, this show that I'm going to, W3L Wrestling Showdown, the season premiere for their W3L Network events that go on YouTube. We've got two matches announced at a tournament. We've got the W3L Wrestling Showdown tournament, as it's now vacated following a resolution. The title's vacated, so they've got to crown a new one, and the tournament starts tonight, and it'll end at Old Year's Fight at the end of December. We've also got Gia Hawks against Taylor Bryden. Taylor Bryden defending the W3L Heavyweight Championship, which he won at Resolution. And we've also got Craig Stevens defending the Breakout Championship against Mayhem Brooks from Elgin. So, hometown lad is going for the title tonight. He had a really good showing at Summer Spectacular, which is in Elgin as well. It was at the Town Hall. And he's looking to capitalise on that and get another win here. So, and come home with the title. So it's going to be a good night. It's going to be a good show. I'm running a little bit late, but as I live literally 5 minutes from the venue, I think I'm going to get away with it. I think I'll be all right. Of course, I'm hoping to have a montage. Possibly some other things, I don't know. You know how I roll with these podcasts. I kind of just wing it and hope for the best. But right now, I think this episode is going to be right in the middle of the Scottish podcast collaboration as well. So there'll be loads of podcasts coming out this week that you may have seen and may have heard. You may have seen things like Crime Divers and lots of murder stuff. And What If and Everything Coincidental. There's loads of good stuff coming up on the week for the Scottish podcast collaboration. But in the meantime, I am just about there at Bishop Mill Hall, as all the lights go. And it's going to be good fun. I said about preview on the website, swnscotland.com. I said that last time they did Bishop Mill Hall, everything went wrong. It wasn't a great show because of that. So this time, much like Summer Spectacular at the Town Hall, I'm hoping that they redeem themselves, maybe. We'll go with that. They redeem themselves with their show tonight at Bishop Mill Hall. It's a cold venue. I forgot to take a hat because it's kind of mild in Elgin just now. Quite mild. It's supposed to be snowing here by Christmas, which is going to be nice. I don't need to drive many places. I think tomorrow going to Aberdeen for WrestleZone is the last time I may need to drive this car the whole year. Looking forward to the show. Like I've said many times, I'm just hoping that it's just not like last year. I don't think it will be. They've got a good amount of guys on there that I really trust to put on a good show. It's just a case of if it works out that way. Looking Sharp's due to be on the show tonight. I think he's on the tournament graphics. I assume he's going to be in the tournament at some point. There's 7 guys announced. That doesn't really work out for a tournament unless there's a 8th mystery person, which I hope there is. I love a tournament. I love rumbles. I love tournaments. I love everything. All of the above. So it's going to be a good night. So I'm just going to try and squeeze in here as I turn right to get to the Bishop Mill Hall. Now to find a parking space. That's the next part. This is stuff you don't need to see. But let's see if we can do it. Damn it. Anyway, right. you don't need to see the rest of this, me trying to find a parking space. So I'm going to stop now, and a snare drop curb. I'm going to stop now, and I'll see you all in the show with the next part, with the montage.
I feel like I'm losing my mind. Is everybody in the world blind? Please, Lord, give me a sign, a sign. I feel like I'm losing my mind. Is everybody in the world blind? Please, Lord, give me a sign, a sign.
I wanna be the greatest. Everybody on their fake shit. I look around and feel like everybody is the fakest. I make this every day and I'm impatient, hoping one day I blow up from the basement. Statement, the top is so vacant. I don't hear shit that I think is amazing. Waiting for my day when I'm playing sold out shows for 1,000 faces. Ay, give me that crown. Get in my way and you'll be put down. It ain't your place, no, this my town. If I want that shit, then I'll get it right now. I'm losing it, the noose it fits. Some loose shit, a stupid myth. You choose to live or choose to dip. You choose to fight or lose your grip and lose a gift. Oh.
I feel like I'm losing my mind. Is everybody in the world blind? Please, Lord, give me a sign, a sign. I feel like I'm losing my mind. Is everybody in the world blind? Please, Lord, give me a sign, a sign.
Yeah. There's no mercy in this world, just hunger-thirsty persons in different versions. Each new update, that shit worsens. Why? Pull back the curtain and you'll see the different vermin. We all have different burdens that all seem to cause disturbance. Y'all, do me a favor, don't treat me like a neighbor. Don't need the different flavors of your problems just to savor. I've got my own issues, I need a comb to get through. Don't need to groan with you, just go get your wrong tissue.
I feel like I'm losing my mind. Is everybody in the world blind? Please, Lord, give me a sign, a sign. I feel like I'm losing my mind. Is everybody in the world blind? Please, Lord, give me a sign, a sign.
That's it, the end of the song. Next time you'll sing along. Trust me, there's nothing wrong. I just need to carry on. Cause society's a myth, put there to make you sit. Listen to what they give. Don't ask questions, shut your lid. Yeah, don't ask questions, shut your lid. I need to run away from this and go get off the grid. Feel like my brain is overloaded, man, I'm losing it. Don't let them tell you what to do, man, they don't know shit.
Here I am at W3L Wrestling Showdown in Elgin at the Bishop Mill Hall. This is, of course, a little area on site. It would be very empty otherwise. This is very
echoey.
Very echoey, yes. I think I've done an interview in here with Emily Hayden, Mike Musso, Kevin Williams, and the Tormentor.
Oh, the Tormentor.
The Tormentor.
Did he say much?
He said a lot of things.
Oh.
I didn't understand any of them, but you know. I am joined by W3L heavyweight champion Taylor Bryden, past guest on the podcast.
Yes, past guest.
Exciting. I've had a blast tonight. How's it like? What's it like coming back up to Elgin?
It's good, I like it. You know what, it feels really different. Like, having been in the town hall last time, then we're in the Bishop Mill Hall this time. But the fans in Elgin are always great. Like, they always bring energy, enthusiasm. There's always like diehard locals that I've been seeing coming to Elgin for at least the last 8 years. So it's nice to see familiar faces and see people like come back and join the product and really show respect and some love to W3L.
It is. Well, I was just thinking about it on my way over. Right? First one I came to was September 2012.
Yeah.
And it was in the town hall. And
yes.
I've came every year since because, you know, not just because I live here, but because I enjoy watching wrestling.
Yeah.
It's just easy to see, and that's always a good thing. And get to see yourself as well. The first time I would have seen you, I don't think you were even on the show. No, you were. You were against CJ Hunter.
Yes, I was CJ Hunter.
So this is a long journey. CJ Hunter, and I think it was the first half main, and now you're the the champ.
The main event. And title, I'm still earning my stripes as a main eventer.
Well, I mean, you've got a hard charge now, it's Gia Hawks.
Yes.
If I remember rightly. Someone who I was speaking to looking sharp as part of his Dane spotting show, who was heaped the praise on this guy. So I'm very excited for this match. You've already fested Doug Williams recently, so, you know, it's...
Everyone's a bit different, though. Everyone's a bit different. Like, the way that I prepare for Doug is completely different to how I'm going to prepare for a guy like Gia Hawks.
Mm-hmm.
He's fast, he's quick, he's agile, and his feet are probably registered weapons.
Possibly.
Yeah. it's I think the same basic cores there, even though the preparations are different for every single person who's going to end up wrestling, you need to do the groundwork. You need to be looking at what they're doing, looking at what they throw, so that you can already have like a plan B, like a contingency plan, if you will, about what you're going to do to deal with certain challenges that come up.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm in the zone. I'm ready to rock tonight. I think I've seen all his stuff, and I think anything he gives me tonight, I can withstand. So yeah.
So by the time this episode comes out, of course, I'm assuming you have retained. We'll find out I do a big montage in these kind of episodes.
Yes.
Of all the photos I take. I was going to do video, but I think if you guys are going to put this out on YouTube for WCL Wrestling Showdown, I think I'll leave it to the professionals for the video.
Wait for the video.
But no, I can't wait. You're doing, like, since we last spoke, you were, like, what was season two, maybe, and since then you've just been everywhere, it seems to be. You're fairly going about, because I'm doing the SWN 100, so it's kind of like PWI stuff, and I won't, unless you want me to tell you after the recording, you've done very well. So you're high up there, because of your work, because it's about win losses and promotions you've been to and all that kind of stuff, and it's just it's really great to see. Just to see since the pandemic ended, just see how much you've went from just, I don't want to say a guy on the roster to the guy on shows, and you're picking up titles at Reckless Intent, picking up titles at W3L. It's great to see the journey.
Yeah, it's a bit, as with everything, like nothing ever ends. The moment you're happy, the moment that you start standing still is the moment that people start going past you. It's something that I've really realised over the last little while, that if you're not evolving and constantly trying to improve, then you're never going to get anywhere in wrestling. Like, as much as a lot of people won't want to say, but I think the guy that I've seen everywhere this year, like guys like Leighton Buzzard, who's been everywhere, Kez Evans, Jack Morris, guys that have putting in so much work and so much dedication to wrestling and so much of their life into it are starting to reap the rewards, and I'm hoping that I can sort of emulate that, and hopefully this is just a breakthrough year and not the sort of crescendo of what I'm going to do. Yeah, I'm hoping to keep going and fire through.
So I won't keep you any longer, because you're in the zone, you're ready for Gia Hawks. This is the Christmas edition, this is the Christmas Carnage episode of the SWN podcast.
Yes.
I'm just going to ask just a random question. What's been the best Christmas present you've ever gotten?
Just off the top of my head, 1999, I walked downstairs, I was 10 years old, and I had opened a little square box, and it was Super Smash Bros, the very first one. And if anybody talks about Christmas to me, that's what I remember, because I ploughed hours in my childhood into that game. And yeah, like, that's the one thing that I always remember, is that I was Super Smash Bros, and it was something that I'd always wanted.
Perfect. Well, I said I'll leave you, I won't take any more of your time, and I won't let you get right into your match with Geox, so we'll find out what happens later. But thank you very much, and good luck for 2023. Hopefully I'll get to speak to you again through the podcast at some point.
Perfect, thanks very much, Billy. I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Even when you feel low, you can still go. Even when you feel slow, you can still go. Even when there's no hope, you can still go. I never answer to no, man, I still go. Go, 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 yo, go, go, go. Hustle hard, hustle every single day. I'll be making moves till I'm buried in my grave.
to the system, I don't wanna be a slave. I've been doing shit my way, or the highway. And in the driveway is a nice range. Cause I grind through the climb, I invite pain. You'll never hear me, bitch, nah, I don't complain. Just gotta flip the switch and you can go and obtain anything you want, anything you need. Your mind's got the key ingredient, it's belief. They're deceived with the negativity, but I just slide right by that energy. Even when you feel low, you can still go. Even when you feel slow, you can still go. Even when there's no hope, you can still go. I never answer to no, man, I still go. Go, 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 go. But even that could change. You could flip the gray matter like some batter in your brain. That's why I say, fake it till you make it, eh? And if you play that game, then you just might make a change. Rearrange all the bad to okay. Take the worst thoughts, saying, turn them to a game. Take the best thoughts, saying, put them on display. On repeat in your brain till you're feeling no more pain. Never slow yourself down, you can do some more. Push past all the pain and you'll find a door. Open it up and finally explore everything that you thought you could never do before. And even when you feel low, you can still go. Even when you feel slow, you can still go. Even when there's no hope, you can still go. I never answer to no, man, I still go. Go, 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 go.
That's the first half of Christmas Carnage, this episode today. I'm flabbergasted at how great that show was. W3L Wrestling Showdown in Elgin. Start to finish, just an excellent show. Kicked off, I'm trying to remember it off the top of my head. We had Saqib Ali versus Tormentor. You know me, I'm not big on the Tormentor, I'll be perfectly honest with you, but they had a really great competitive match. Really great hot finish as well. There's some dissension between Saqib Ali and Craig Stevens. That was fantastic to watch and see play out. What did we have after that? Oh god, now I'm drawing a blank. It was Iron Drew Marshall against Hugo Harris. It was the first time I'd seen Hugo Harris wrestle. Again, highly entertaining match. We had a point where the kids in the front row all helped pull Hugo split legged on the ring ropes, on the ring post. That was just hilarious to watch. My first half main was Mayhem Brooks against Craig Stevens. That was just huge, so heated. Everyone was behind Mayhem Brooks, a hometown guy, a hometown boy. Unfortunately, he didn't pick up the win. He didn't win the title, but he won by disqualification. But the crowd were heavy. Heavily behind Mayhem Brooks, and he put on a fantastic match as well to go with it. Second half, we had Luke King Sharp and Tom Fulton, and you can't go wrong with that combination, really. Luke King Sharp is just one of the best, in my opinion, one of the best wrestlers in this country, possibly even Europe, maybe even the world. He's just that good, and to have the match between him and Tom Fulton, a lot of fun, a lot of hilarity, just a good wrestling match. And then the main event, we spoke about the entertainment factor of the previous matches. This was a straight up main event, just title match, heavyweight title match, wrestling match. Taylor Bryden, the champion, against Gaia Hawks. I'd never seen Gaia Hawks before. Hadn't even looked on him on YouTube, really. I just kind of got a feel, a vibe, what his deal was when it comes to in-ring stuff. He would be a flippy dude. And oh my god, this match was just brilliant. It was main event match. There was drama. These guys, there was no clear-cut bad guy, good guy. So the crowd were pretty much split between Gaia Hawks and Taylor Bryden as well. And the finish was incredible. There was a lot of athleticism. It was just a really, really great wrestling match. And I've had an absolute blast, and if this is the sign of things to come for my weekend, I am very excited. So we'll have the montage. I don't know what I'm doing with the montage and our little interview there with Taylor Bryden. Thank you very much, W3L, for setting that up for me. I just tweeted them, DM'd them Thursday, just going, is there any chance I could speak to a couple guys? And I got the champ. I got the W3L heavyweight champion, Taylor Bryden, to speak to. So that was cool. I got to see the repainted W3L heavyweight championship. And oh my God, I've never seen a belt that it's went from, to be honest, it looked like crap before, and now it looks like a really good prestigious title, which is just great. I love belts. I'm a belt guy. Give me a belt to look at or to hold, and I am you there. I am your guy. I'll have probably a proper write-up on the SWN website next week, or by the time this episode comes out, I'll probably be on there. I'll probably have done it. So yeah, next up is WrestleZone Christmas Chaos, Return of the Cage, which is tomorrow in this world, in this timeline that I'm in, and time is a construct and all that. So I have had an absolute blast at W3L, and I know it's going to be like 5 days after the fact, but I've had a great time, and I can't wait to write about it. I can't wait to put up pictures, can't wait to do the montage, can't wait to go back and watch my chat with Taylor, and hope that the Echoey Hall, the Bishop Mill Hall, doesn't just drown out all the sound and all the chatting and whatnot, because we had a good time. So yeah, next time you see me, hopefully it should be daylight, I think, because I'll be driving through to Aberdeen at about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, so it should be daylight, and we'll do a little bit of a hello. Maybe I'll get some questions in overnight, and I'll be able to answer them on, I don't know which part I'll be driving. I'll be either driving from Elgin, especially Rothes. I haven't lived in Rothes for a very long time. Elgin to Bucky when I go drop off my son, or from Bucky to Aberdeen. I might do a bit of recording at that point as well. You know me, I like to stop and get a bit of food on the way because I'm a fat man. So next part, don't know, it'll be daylight. Might do, I don't know. I have no idea what I'm going to do, I'll be honest with you. But stay tuned, there's more stuff coming up. Have a good one. And we're back for part two of the SWN podcast, Christmas Carnage. Don't know why I've said that particular way, but I'm back in the car. I don't need to introduce myself again, do I? Because this is the second half of one episode. So, we're on our way to WrestleZone, Christmas Chaos, Return of the Cage at Dainston Community Centre in Aberdeen. A venue I have no idea where it is. Not even a little bit. Usually, For Curl, I kind of knew it was near the hospital and near Big Tesco, so I kind of had a rough idea. I have no idea for Dainston, so once I get to, I don't know, Inverurie or something, I'll get the old map app out and we'll be all good to go. So this is the first part of my journey. The first leg is going to Bucky and dropping off my son at my parents, so his grandparents, obviously. So this is just the first little bit. I thought I'd at least record this bit because it's daylight, to show that time has passed since the first half bit at W3L Wrestling Showdown. A show that I'm still really, really so impressed by. It was such a good night, a good event. And we've got a little chat with W3L Heavyweight Champion Taylor Bryden as well. So that was all cool. So it's been a good start to this weekend, and now here is not just the main event, but an event I'm just absolutely buzzing for. I cannot wait for Christmas Chaos. Christmas Chaos, I missed it last year because I went to W3L. Did an afternoon show and wrestled over in the evening, so I kind of half hoped to maybe do both, and this knob has stopped in front of me, and now I'm stuck. I hate people. Anyway, right. Just go reverse the scooter a moment and get out of here. Absolute tool. Anyway, right. So, Christmas Chaos. This is the reality of this driving bit for the podcast. So, Christmas Chaos. We've got So 7 matches on the card. 7 absolute matches I can't wait to see. It's going to start off with the VIP ticker holder match. It's Omar Mohamed, of course, from Family Fortunes, aka who says Judge Judy is television's favourite talent show judge. I mean, to be fair, there are some talents in there in Judge Judy. Some talents of just avoiding to pay money and what have you. So good, Mr. Judge Judy. Omar Mohamed against Chris Archer and Tommy Raiden in a triple threat in the pre-show. Tommy Raiden, this is his first actual full show. He did the Trinity Center, Trinity Center takeover. I did that show, and I'm guessing he did some gala shows throughout the year. So we've got that triple threat. It seems like it's a fight to get out of the pre-show. See, as last month, it was Chris Archer, Omar Mohamed, and Rhys Dawkins. And Dawkins won, and he's now on the main show for Christmas Chaos. So it seems to be like they're fighting out of the pre-show to get onto the main card. So it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm going to say that so many times, I can just tell. I'm going to say that's a lot of fun, quite a lot. We've also got a tag team match. We've got the Outfit against Mr. P and Sean Johnson. I'm going to guess I'll have tag team championship implications for next year, possibly at Summer Hill Showdown. We'll see whoever wins this might go on to challenge at Summer Hill. That's what we got tag titles on the line. We've got Bruiser Brad Evans and Ryan Riley of the Foundation of the Future against the Fair City Saints, Alex Webb and Air Miles, which I'm buzzing for. I haven't seen the Fair City Saints as a unit together before. I've seen them wrestle separately around the Northeast, so I'm looking forward to actually seeing them as a unit and a team, and this should be a hell of a good match because it's just two really, really well-versed teams, two teams that are really work well together as well. So there's a lot of good stuff that's going to come from that. We've got the Christmas Brawl. We've got Captain Al Sterling against Caleb Valhalla. This might be the end of the chapter of Caleb Valhalla and Al Sterling. It came to a head at Regal Rumble when Valhalla finally had enough of Captain Allen being a bit of a wally. So we had that. This is now Christmas Brawl, so all Christmas items are legal. I'll be interested to see what shenanigans are afoot for that. Tri-Couch Championship match. We've got Mickey Vigo defending in a fatal four-way against Ronan King, Rhys Dawkins, as I mentioned, and Conor Malloy. It's going to be fast. There's going to be a lot of stuff happening in that match. There's going to be a lot of just things, stuff and things, and people, bodies flying all over the place. I'm really bad at predicting, so I don't want to say who I think is going to win because I'm most likely going to be wrong. But I think I have a gut feeling. We'll say a gut feeling who's going to win, and if I'm right, if I'm wrong, then you won't know. But if I'm right, then you'll probably see a bit of a smug look on my face when I do the post show bit in my car after the event itself. We'll talk about the main event in a second. We've got Loser Leaves Wrestle Zone match between Scotty Swift and Brian Tucker. So we've got that. The loser will, of course, leave Wrestle Zone. I'm still of the opinion I want to see Loser Leaves Town and have them lose in Aberdeen and then come back in Montrose and come back in Inverary. But, you know, that's why I don't book things, because that would be absolutely ridiculous. Trying to think what else we've got before I get to the main event. I think I've covered everything. I've probably forgot one, and I'll remember it as I go through the card before I actually go into the show. So we've got the main event now. The main event, it's triple threat steel cage match for the undisputed WrestleZone Championship. We've got Zach Dynamite, champion. We've got Damien, the former champion, and we've got Aspen Faith, 12-year journey. And he started first match of Christmas Chaos with a championship match against Bingo Balance, you pointed out on Twitter. And now this is his time. He's in the main event steel cage match. I don't want to get confident. I don't want to, because I thought he was going to win Halloween Hijinks. I hoped he would win Harvey Anarchy, even though I kind of thought it was going to be Zach Dynamite. So I don't know how I'm going to feel at this show. I don't know how I'm going to cope. I watched back some clips of Regal Rumble, and I looked just like a distraught mess by the end of it, or during the show as well, with my head in my hands, and it's most reactive I've ever been at a show. And now potentially we could see Asmer Faith as Undisputed Wrestling Champion. We might not. So, as is tradition for my WrestleZone journeys, I like to get a monster. And the last couple of times I've done this, I did it for... I did it for Dooney as well. I've brought, bought Ultra Gold, I think. Definitely did for Anarchy, definitely did it for Holly Hijinks, but I'm not falling for it this time. We've got Ultra Fiesta Mango this time. I'm not jinxing it. Aspen hopefully winning by buying an Ultra Gold again, even though I do love the pineapple flavours. Monster, sponsor me. So, got a lot of good stuff. I can't wait for the show. It's just, this is the culmination of my year with wrestling. This is the last one I go to this year. And it's been a really good, great year. I've been to a good few shows. I was Summerhill, Ellen, Anarchy, you know, Rumble, Anarchy, then Miss Battle of the Nations. Went to W3L Summer Spectacular, then it was Hijinks, Inveruri, then Hijinks, then I missed the Training Academy shows, W3L last night, and then we've got Christmas Chaos tonight. So it's been a really, really packed year, considering that I thought that, especially the later half of the year, I would go to generally no shows, because I would have a newborn, but here I am, so I'm going to wrestling. So it just means that Granny, Grandad, and Bucky get to see their grandson a bit more, which, you know, works for everyone. It works for everyone. I had a fear that we weren't going to go to the show or yesterday's show because stuck with the cold as well. The boy got stuck with the cold. The folks got stuck with the cold. Kelly got stuck with the cold. And the only thing in my household that didn't get stuck with the cold was the dog. Even then, she always looks a little bit sad for herself because she's a little bit proud about Jack being an entity in this house, in this household. But yeah, so a lot of good matches on the cards tonight. If it's a fraction as good as last night's W3L show, I'm going to be absolutely buzzing. But there's so many matches that I can't wait to see. Can't wait to see the outcomes of. Can't wait to see what stories start to begin as we're going to approach Regal Rumble next year. We're starting to get a little bit of little bits of story to go into the year. But really, Summerhill is kind of where proper the road to the Regal Rumble begins. But we'll get to see, hopefully, some of the stories for the year conclude and see the beginnings of next year's direction as well. So it's always a pleasure to go to WrestleZone shows. It's always a pleasure to go there and to drive to Aberdeen and see these events, because it's just, it's so much fun. I enjoy the crew, I enjoy the talent, I enjoy the wrestling, and I don't enjoy the journey so much, but we'll do what we do. So the next bit will probably be that little bit where I do a video of the ringside area, just for a moment, and then a montage, post-show, and then I'll see if I get any questions afterwards, and do a bit back in the studio. You know how this works right now for these road trip episodes. I've done like four of them now, three of them, something, I don't know. So yeah, next time you'll see me, it will probably be in darkness after the show, in Deanston Community Centre in Aberdeen. So, WrestleZone Christmas Chaos, Return of the Cage, oh my.
It is the Drip God, the greatest 19-year-old wrestler in the world, Ronan King, and welcome to SWN.
This is not a Christmas song. just a boy. Christmas brought so much joy. Couldn't wait for the presents and laughter. I couldn't sleep late at night, looking for Santa with lights. Those are the memories I still remember. Then I became a man, lost sight of who I am. But right in front of me was the answer. 'Cause on Christmas I feel joy, and I turn back to a boy. The answer is to stay young.
Hey, this is Tim Strange, and you're listening to SWN.
By worth, I desire your worst, so you can just hide while I work. I ain't tired, you first. I'll write a second, third verse about the lies you go disperse. You never did shit, I know it hurts.
Something deep inside won't let me quit. I swear that I'm inspired by all this shit. Tell me that I can't and I won't. That's what guides me the most. Fuck your lies, I'll do what I want.
Even when you feel low, you can still go. Even when you feel slow, you can still go. Even when there's no hope, you can still go. I never answer to no, man, I still go.
Go, 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 yo, go, go, go.
Hustle hard, hustle every single day. I'll be making moves till I'm buried in my grave. To the system, I don't wanna be a slave. I've been doing shit my way, or the highway. And in the driveway is a nice range. 'Cause I grind through the climb, I invite pain. You'll never hear me, bitch, nah, I don't complain. Just gotta flip the switch and you can go and obtain anything you want, anything you need. Your mind's got the key ingredient, it's belief. They deceive with the negativity, but I just slide right by that energy. Even when you feel low, you can still go. Even when you feel slow, you can still go. Even when there's no hope, you can still go. I never answer to no, man, I still go.
Go, 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 go.
You got a mind, but even that could change. You could flip the gray matter like some batter in your brain. That's
way. Fake it till you make it, eh? And if you play that game, then you just might make a change. Rearrange all the bad to okay. Take the worst thoughts saying, turn them to a game. Take the best thoughts saying, put them on display. On repeat in your brain till you're feeling no more pain. Never slow yourself down, you can do some more. Push past all the pain and you'll find a door. Open it up and finally explore everything that you thought you could never do before. And even when you feel low, you can still go. Even when you feel slow, you can still go. Even when there's no hope, you can still go. I never answer to no, man, I still go.
Go, 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 go. And this is SWN. Skull! Skull! Skull!
Searching for greatness in a sea of the dying and shameless. A sea of the aimless. I don't wanna be one of the nameless. I'ma wake up with the mindset that one day I'm gonna make it. And I don't think I'll be fine if I don't break my limitations. Don't try to stop me, I exist to write my own story. I'll make a decision if I want some peace or if I want the glory. Yeah, don't want a life that is complacent or possibly boring. I just want a life that is worth every day exploring.
My whole life I just wanted someone who would notice me. My whole life I just wanted to be somebody to be. Yeah, I just wanna be great. Yeah, I just wanna be great. Yeah, I just wanna be great. Yeah, yeah,
yeah, I just wanna be great.
Appreciate all that is vacant. It's just for the taking. If you make up your mind, you can take it. I'm never complacent. I would work in a mansion or basement, yeah. There's no replacement for persistence. It's a patience, yeah. In this life, I wanna be soaring. To feel sun inside when it's pouring. And I'll fight till anxiety is foreign. I'm so sick of my mind's extortion.
My whole life I just wanted someone who would notice me. My whole life I just wanted to be somebody to be.
Yeah, I just wanna be great. Yeah, I just wanna be great. Yeah, I just wanna be great. Yeah, yeah,
yeah, I just wanna be.
Wow, so that has been WrestleZone Christmas Chaos Return of the Cage. You would have seen the montage beforehand. Jesus, it's been a night. I'll probably do something like at the end when I get my bearings and that, when I get back into the SWN studio. But what a night. Aspen Faith is the undisputed WrestleZone champion. He completes the Grand Slam, he completes the Triple Crown, he has won all the belts, in WrestleZone that he can win. This has been an incredible night, incredible weekend of wrestling. I'm so happy. I'm elated. I am shaking. I was shaking through the whole main event, so some of the photos are going to get a little bit dodgy at that point, just because I was just like, shaking through all of it. But elsewhere, though, just kicking off the full show, the main show, with the Fair City Saints with the tag titles. Wow, I love the team, the Fair City Saints. Have we said it for a long time? I really enjoy the team, and see Alex and Air Miles get the titles. That's even better. I'm speaking as of like when this goes up. I think it'll be Wednesday the 7th, and I was speaking to Alex on Tuesday the 6th of December. So we'll be able to speak about that and have a lot of fun, and be able to talk about that along with all our Christmas shenanigans I kind of have in mind as well. I might do another little bit when I get on the road, because I don't think I can formulate all my thoughts. But we had Scotty Swift lose to Brian Tucker in a loser leave WrestleZone match, and I properly, like, it's the same when Crusher announced his retirement at Aberdeen Anarchy. I was like, it'll be sad, but I'm quite an emotional robot, like a robot when it comes to emotion. But as soon as Scotty lost, and a tear went in my eye, I felt it. I just felt the emotion. I felt his emotion as well. It was deflating, which I think may have impacted the next match as well, which was Alan and Caleb. I think it was a good match, but I think it got kind of, it was harder to get the crowd back invested after they just saw Scotty lose and leave WrestleZone. So it impacted it in that way, but tonight has been amazing. Again, I said this weekend has been amazing. Two great shows, two great wrestling shows, full of entertainment, full of emotion, full of just variety. And this is why I love going to wrestling. I know I say this every road trip episode. I go on about how I love going to see wrestling, because it's the best form of entertainment for me personally. It's you get all that angst and emotion and anger, and you get everything out of you in the space of 2 hours. You get to see all of it. You get to see favorites. You get to find new favorites. You get to just get in touch with anything, your childlike emotions. It was just an incredible event, and thank you to W3L, thank you to WrestleZone for putting on two incredible shows. I'm sure I'll have written in the next couple of days. I'll have some written stuff on the SW in Scotland website, a review, and probably two reviews, maybe a thoughts on, I don't know, I haven't really formulated all the brain cells about, because I'm still really shaken by the main event. It was just ace, and I'm sorry for all the A's and O's, because I'm still shaken by the whole show. That's 2022 done in my wrestling calendar. I think we've got an episode, we've got an interview with Alex Webb, and then I'll probably do a preview of the year-end awards. But yeah, I'll leave that for now. I'll get back, I'll get on the road, and I might pop in again before I get back to the studio. So, it's been a great night.
2 hours later.
And we're back. Just picked up the boy from Bucky, from Granny and Grandad's. So I was having a wee think about just tonight's show, Christmas Chaos, Return of the Cage, for WrestleZone. And the more my thought was, like, seeing Aspen Faith win the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship, I was trying to cast my mind back, because I think it goes without saying, I've many favourite wrestlers, but Aspen's probably my the favourite. The more I think about it, that is the case. And I've disappeared. Hello, I'm still here. Don't worry about it. It's just gone a little bit dark, because I'm now just outside Bucket. And I was trying to think, like, when my kind of favouritism or fanness began for Aspen, and I can't think of a moment in general where that it happened. It was just like, you just don't have the moment where it goes, it clicks. This is my guy now. This is the favourite. He can do no wrong. He's just my favourite wrestler. So the first time I would have seen him wrestle was at Abri Attic in 2013. This is the first Abri Attic show at the Ballroom. And it was a six-man tag match. It was him, James Midas, and Scott Maverick. And he was against the Granite Say Hotshots and Hacksaw Jim Duggan. That was my first experience seeing this guy come out. I think he had the pink and black at that point. He had the pigtails and all that kind of stuff. And you know what? I think the weirdest thing, the most unique point at that time for him, they made, like, I remembered him, like, as a wrestler, was he had like a shoulder like support. So when I crossed the arm, it was like a sling support for his shoulder. And I think I just thought that was such a cool thing. I don't know why. Can tell you for why, but I thought it was just a cool look. It was just something memorable. So I can't remember, like, the next time I've seen him, maybe the Rumble the year after. I have no earthly idea. But that was my first kind of memory. And now 9 years later, I'm seeing him with the Undisputed Wrestling Championship. It was a great night. It was a great show, and I'm going to say that again and again because it was. It's been a great weekend for me as a wrestling fan and as a quote unquote podcaster. Got to meet a lot of wrestlers again. I'm getting a bit more confident speaking to wrestlers, which is nice. I would think now it's the grand old age of 32. I can get used to speaking to people, and I think I am. And I'm very aware to the video viewers, this is horrible, this is awful, but you're just getting darkness because I'm driving in the dark. And my lights are on, don't worry about it, someone's home. So yeah, it was just a fantastic night. Again, I'll probably have a segment when I'm back in the SWN Towers, the studio, again, quote unquote, where I can discombobulate my thoughts and feelings and emotions. But I've had two nights, two great shows, and for anyone who's on the fence about going to wrestling, if you see a poster for a wrestling show local to you, in most cases it's going to be a good night. You're going to find something to enjoy, you're going to find someone to enjoy. You might go there with no rhyme or reason, know anyone at the show, you might not know any of the wrestlers. I almost guarantee you, when that show ends, you're going to see someone, you would have seen someone that you enjoyed, that you've liked seeing, that you're like, oh, the show, I don't know, it wasn't for me. I'm a big fan of the wrestling, but I saw this guy, and he had spiky red hair, and he everyone loved him, and everyone thought he was the best thing ever, and he was really charismatic, he was really cool. And that might be your opinion. You might not go back to the wrestling show, but at least you'll always have that lasting memory of that match, that event, that show. Because even now, I mean, my folks, they went to a couple of WWE shows with me for my first couple, because I was too young to try and get transport there. And they went to a couple of the UPW shows that were in Bucky, and a couple of W3L ones in Elgin. And even though it's not really their thing as well, it's not really their genre of entertainment, they always have memories of something happening or someone from the shows. And it's just the cool thing about wrestling, is you get to have these moments and you get the core memories. I am rambling, I'm aware of that, because it is quarter to midnight at this point. And I've got a very grumpy baby in the back seat who's needed his bed, and I've got a very grumpy 32-year-old quote-unquote podcaster listening to his voice, and probably going to get a bit grumpy in the front seat. And I'm hoping, praying and hoping, that I'm going to meet Kelly outside the Turkish Kebabber in Elgin, and I'll have some chips and cheese ready waiting for me. Here we go. So yeah, I'm going to stop now and go, and we'll do the studio bit. because this is terrible viewing for people that are on YouTube, that I've had to spend the last 5 minutes in absolute darkness and then my face now, and when the cars come the other way. So I'm going to get past this little windy road bit, and we'll wrap up and go to the studio. But yeah, I hope you've enjoyed the montage. I think I only took one video of the actual show, which was Aspen doing a moonsault, so it'll be in there somewhere probably, or it might actually be next to separate the two segments of me and then go, that's what I'm going to do. So the next thing you see will be Aspen Faith doing a moonsault, and then I will be back in the studio for some roundup and whatnot. So again, thank you for continuing to watch. If you are still watching, if you're listening, this has been probably better for you, because it's the exact same, it's just a darkness of a screen right now, because it's quarter to midnight on December 3rd in 2022. So we'll see you later.
Hello, we're back in SWN Towers, back in the studio. There's been a lot of montages, I'm not gonna lie there. I think I did about 7 of them, because I got a little bit snap happy and I got some themes going and different music, and this is like a radio show. This is kind of what SWN Podcast has become on this Christmas Carnage edition of the show. And this is our penultimate episode of the season. We plan to have the holiday special / finale with Alex Webb next. And then it'll be, and that'll be it until New Year. I might do a preview for the year-end awards, but that's pretty much what we've got going on. And I've got to do some rescheduling in the New Year, and I've got some folk I want to get onto the show as well, come January into February, what have you, for season 5. Season 5, again, I don't know whether I'm still going to go back into full-time once a week, but I'll just see what happens. So, yeah, the dust is kind of cleared. I still haven't done anything like written wise on the two shows I went to see. I'm still a little bit just jogging my memory and trying to recover. And some reason, because of all the outdoorness of my weekend, my throat is starting to close up a little bit again. So I apologize for the reverb of the bassiness of my phlegmy voice. But we do have some questions. So before I get into that, though, I'm going to do some like a big bit about Scottie Swift on the review, or the thoughts on WrestleZone, Christmas Chaos, Return of the Cage, because I'm still trying to process it, because I'm still a little bit shocked. I did say in the queue, when I was speaking to Kyle and Kaylin, that of K&K Wrestle Factory, that it was a possibility, but I didn't think it would actually come to fruition. I didn't know how to react at the time, so it was still a little bit tender, because I've spoken to Scotty quite a lot, either at shows or through the podcast. We've got about 9 hours worth of content just speaking to Scotty, and we haven't even scratched the surface. So I'm hoping next year, when I've got a bit more time, we'll be able to get another conversation in with Scotty and just again put the worlds to rights with a couple beers and just see what happens. But fingers crossed that there's loads of time to do these things, hopefully, and we'll find time in 2023. So yeah, got questions about the show from people. Again, so sorry about the voice, so I won't make this bit too long. We've got Connor Malloy coming in with, are you just glad I didn't land on you at the show again? It was bloody close, though. you're really kind of, you're seeing where the limit is, where you can land like that close to me. That was a really cool spot. It was crazy. I got a couple pictures of it. It doesn't do it justice, because it was just nuts. And honestly, if there were so many, anyone could have won that four-way for the Tri-Couch Championship. It was Vago who retained. I kind of thought Ronan might do it, and then I thought maybe Connor's going to end the year with the title if he started the year with the belt. I just don't know. There were so many things that could have happened in that match, and yes, I am glad that you didn't land on me. That was very much appreciated. Ronan King, how did Ronan steal the show with his drip yet again? Well, he was the Christmas gift. When I did show, I showed Kelly the picture of Ronan in his lovely gear. It was like a red, white, and blue Christmas jumper / present kind of ensemble. She did ask if he had a receipt. So I don't know if that went well with her. So it was really cool. I love it. I love the themed gear. I'm very much looking forward to see what he does for things like Anarchy in the future and things. I just want to I'm just very much happy seeing wrestlers just like go a little bit out there when they come to themed shows, and we'll see what happens in the future. Age of Sensation TV's Omar Muhammad from Family Fortunes, he came in with a little bit of a doubt because he had some fabulous shoes, and there's a name for them. I'm absolutely positive, and he'll probably comment on Twitter once I put this episode out what they're actually called. But damn, they look comfy. They've got a little like curls at the end. It's just, yeah, look ace. I don't think I'd pull them off. I've got fat feet. We've got Callum coming in. Callum Bruce, of course, asking who's next for Aspen. I don't know. I wouldn't bet against. It was supposed to be like the war final. It's supposed to be an end. So I think it would still be a good match, but I don't think it should be Zach and Aspen again. I think that should kind of breathe a little bit. Just give that a moment, a show or two to breathe. I don't know about Damien going again. I think they should leave that trio of matches or trios together just for a little bit, even if they revisit it back at Nations or something like that, or Hijinx next year. Trying to think of the winners and losers that came out of Christmas Chaos. I mean, weirdly enough, it really should be. I'd love to see a match with Omar. He won the pre-show, so it'd be cool to see him go for a title in WrestleZone. It really should be Brian Tucker, though, which is not as sad as I thought I'd say. He beat Scotty Swift with nefarious means. We'll put that aside. But he beat Scotty Swift, and he should be challenged. He's a former Undisputed WrestleZone champion, so is Tucker as well. So really, that's kind of your big name coming out of it. Caleb, perhaps, but it looks like he's still got a little bit of a bone to pick with Alan when Alan and the outfit shaved his head. So it's blown the whole scene wide open. Who come in and that as well, because Aspen's works. Across the country as well, around the country, in places like Reckless and First City and Discovery. I would love to see that belt go traveling. Jason Reed tried it, didn't do it for a little bit with Tri-Couch title. He took Discovery to defend it. I would love to see Aspen go with that belt. I would have loved to see Zach do it as well. Go around with the rest of the zone and dispute championship and just defend it with names everywhere. Go to Discovery and defend it against Mark Haskins or bring Ian Skinner up and get Ian Skinner in a match with Aspen again up here. So yeah, there's so many things that could happen, and things that could have happened when Zach was champion, and things that can happen Aspen's champion. So I don't know. I was actually speaking to Kelly last night about she was planning to come back to the Regal Rumble. That's her kind of our penciled in date for coming back to the wrestling following the birth of our child. So just as an FYI for anyone who's going, where is she? Is she alive? Cheers. So what was I saying? I was speaking to her about the Regal Rumble and thinking who could arguably win it. And I was going through some names in my head. And again, as much as I'd love to see Zach or Damien win it, I think, again, that needs to breathe a little bit. I probably would have even put Scotty in just as an outside bet. But, of course, that's not going to happen now. The name that keeps coming to my head, I don't know if it's just because of biasness, because that I think this wrestler is incredible as a human and as a wrestler, but I would love to see Avery Anarchy main event next year at Aspen Faith against Caleb Valhalla for the Undisputed Championship. I don't know who would win. And even then, I'd be like, I don't know who to pick or what to pick, but I would love to see Aspen and Caleb main event of Avery Anarchy next year. I mean, even then, I would love to see Bruiser Brad and Aspen have had some battles in WrestleZone and in Discovery. I would love to see maybe that go into a main event kind of scene over the title. But yeah, I think Aspen versus Caleb, Aubrey Anarchy, that's my early-ish pick for the main event next year. Callum also asking what you wanted for Christmas. Well, besides world peace, I don't know. I'm at that age now. I'm 32 and I don't want for anything. Like, oh, it'd be ace if I got PS5. That would be amazing. I would love it. I'd play it. You know, all cool. But really, if I got up on Christmas Day and this is gonna sound so sad, and there was just a bunch of cool gifts from my family for my son. That'd be cool for me. I'd be happy with that, as long as there's food in the fridge, and I'm gonna be fine. That's it. I'm now just a guy who likes to eat, and I don't think that's a surprise for folk. Before I move on to the next question, though, I did because what's next for who's next for Aspen? I did get a bit of merch. Wait a minute. I've also unplugged my headset. This is, of course, staying into the podcast because I'm a professional. So I've got a bit of merch, which I've stuck my cable now, so I can't stand up. But it's the new Aspen Faith t-shirt. I think I'm still missing the Rust Devil. I know it's on T-Mill. I'll eventually get it. But I think that's it. I think I got one Kings of Catch one. So I've got a bunch of Emerson, didn't get any Filthy Generation ones, and that. But I've got a fair few Aspen t-shirts now, and this is the most latest edition. You can go at the Aspen Faith on Twitter, DM them. It's £20, probably plus postage. Give them a shout, and it's cool. It's a cool t-shirt. I'd love to show you. Hang on, I'll take my headset off and I'll show you properly. Hang on. There you go, audio listeners. Apologies for that. So that was cool. I got that. That was my wee bit of merch. Also got to put on a chemise as well with Omar. So I apologise in advance for me stretching that thing out because we're very different body shapes when it comes to that. And I got cool pictures. I got a picture with you've seen it. You would have seen it already if you watched the video version. But I got a picture with the new tag team champions Alex Webb and Stephen Air Miles, which was cool. That was cool. And Alex had his YouTube plaque with him also. So that was interesting to see. I'll probably never see one myself with my name on it. But, you know, it was nice to see that they actually do physically exist. Anyway, last thing I've got is just a wee statement here. Hang on, I'll see if there's anything else. I've got one. Not a question, but a statement from Scotty Swift. Thank you for all the coverage you have given WrestleZone over the years. It will continue. It will continue. Unless something, the worst thing happens in the world, whether I'm no longer on this earth, or, you know, I think we all know what the other thing would be, which I don't think would happen. I will continue to shout from the rooftops about WrestleZone, and I think now I've spoken to more people. I don't know if they just say it to me when I'm speaking to interviewing people, just because they know that I'll hurt my interest, or maybe I'll give them a little bit more advertisement. I wouldn't. It's just what happens. But I like that when I'm speaking to people and ask what companies want to go to or what they want to try, that WrestleZone does come up in conversation, and well it should, because these shows are just so much fun to go to, and the atmosphere, the camaraderie, the friendship. I'm not going to get into the whole I've got anxiety, I'm not great with people, I'm not a great conversationalist, but I feel so comfortable at these shows that it's just so nice. It's just so nice to go to and see these shows and events. That was it. I think we're going to wrap up the show because it's gone over an hour somehow, because I've done, like seven bloody montages and all that kind of stuff and videos and all that. So this has been quite a put together episode of the SWN podcast. I'm probably going to watch it back. There'll be stuff missing. There'll be some error on the video that means that something gets cut out, but I try my best with these things for a bit of Christmas carnage for you to watch and listen to, so hopefully you enjoyed it. I'm sorry for the shaking. I'll see if I'll stabilize it. But that's it. That's my last wrestling for the year. I've got one more chat scheduled, and then I've got to try and reschedule ones with the likes of Lucha DS into next year. I've got some earmarked for other chats with people. I've also got an idea for a new spin-off podcast as well that we'll be doing hopefully into next year. Don't know when, maybe mid next year, that I'll do. Just need to kind of formulate it and confirm and think about it more. But that's it. I'm going to go rest my throat because it sounded awful. And thank you for continuing to support SWN. This has been a great year for our listenership, for our website views. It's been the second most viewed year ever in our history. And obviously the listens, if I think by the time this comes out, we're probably about 17,000 in total, which is insane. I don't know why I'm just glad that you're listening. Even if you're not enjoying, if you're listening, thank you. I'm going to leave everyone to it. I keep saying that, and I'm still not wrapping up. So if you want to find out more about SWN, swnscotland.com, you can go onto our socials at ScottRestNet. I think that's pretty much everywhere. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. You can also go onto youtube.com/ScottishWrestlingNetwork. You should find everything there, every podcast that we've done, a video version at least. And there's some bonus stuff on the podcast feed on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. And I think that's about it. That's it. We're good. Right. Have a great Christmas, folks. Merry Christmas, and have a good New Year. Oh, before I go, thank you again. I've just mentioned wrestling in that back half, but thank you to the guys at Worldwide Wrestling League as well for facilitating an interview with Taylor Bryden. Love speaking to Taylor, so it was a great chance to have a chat with them again. But anyway, that's it. We're out. We're definitely going this time. Merry Christmas and happy Festivus.